Hello, YouTubies. This is King Scrab, and just let me slurp some white wine. Absolutely delicious. Now, I want to talk about this flat earth model, which has flooded the alternative scene in recent months. It does have some interesting components. For instance, it makes people more innovative with their ideas towards science and creative as well. But if you question everything, which is what the motto of these cults tend to come up with, question everything, you see that a lot, it can lead to paranoia, which is the risk. And where these cults tend to die off is paranoia, where people are paranoid about everything they see. Everything's a problem. Oh my God, there's problems over here, there's problems over here. You'll see that a lot in cults. If you start getting paranoid, you have a bigger issue. So be careful of that. But I congratulate them on making people more creative towards their ideas towards science. I suppose that's a good thing. But when they talk about the flat Earth model, they don't mean that the Earth is totally flat, of course. They understand that there's hills and valleys, etc. And it doesn't suddenly turn into a ball. That's what they're saying. I actually believe the opposite to that. I believe that the Earth is more of a sphere and it isn't a flat plane of existence. Now, if you question anybody in that scene, almost everybody now, I mean, originally it was everybody, but if you question everybody in that scene, whether the moon reflects the sun's light, they will say, yes, it does. Fair enough. And we can see the sun is reflect, the moon is actually reflecting the sun's light. From the angle from when the sun comes in and it hits the face of the moon, and you get these semi moons, half a moons, full moon business stuff going on. So, of course, the moon is reflecting the sun's light. We can see that plain as day. But here's the crux. Here's the biggest problem for you guys. Explain the full moon. Halfway between sunset and sunrise. There's no sun around. The sun has disappeared. It's the middle of night, yet there's a full moon. Now, when I ask somebody a question about this, people are saying, oh, the moon emits its own light. Well, that's absolutely bloody waffle going on there. The moon does not emit its own light, no matter how much gaslighting you can come up with. I think anybody with any common sense will see that the moon is reflecting the sun's light based on where the sun is in reference to the sky, and how, when you look at it, you can see the arcs coming up from the sun coming up this way. So it is reflecting the sun's light. How can it there be a full moon in the middle of night when there's no sun hitting the earth on that side? On a flat plane of existence, that's impossible. Because the sunlight has to come from behind the earth to do that. Now, it doesn't necessarily mean directly behind it. It can be from one side hitting the moon full on. If you've got like a triangle here, the moon's here, the earth's here, you can have the sun hitting the moon this way with sunlight, and it will reflect it back on the earth. That would be a full moon. But it couldn't possibly be doing it on a flat plane of existence where the sun is over here and the moon's here. That's impossible. You can't have a full moon in that way. Because, for instance, we know the sun is further away from the earth than the moon. Even the flat earth people will actually believe that. Because the eclipse, for instance, if the moon was further away, the sun would eclipse the moon. So definitely the moon is closer to the earth. We also know when there's an eclipse happening that things go dark. So the moon itself does not emit its own light. Now some of them will start saying, oh yes it does. No it doesn't. They'll come up with some stupid video or some Photoshop and say explain that. Well, I just explained it. It's a Photoshop and you're also producing a video for somebody's channel, which could be something they just created or whatnot, and it could also be the fact that it's not a full eclipse. But when there is a full eclipse, things go dark because the moon is not making its own light. Afraid it isn't. So the flat Earth model cannot exist. It cannot possibly exist if you have a full moon at night. And when I say full moon, I mean where you can see the full moon and it's emitting it, well, it's actually reflecting the sun's light. Because on a flat plane of existence, the sunlight will be coming from an angle downwards towards the moon. So it wouldn't even hit the face of the moon. The only way it would work if it's come from behind the Earth. Now, as I said, not totally behind it, but far enough where it can actually hit the front of the face. That would actually work. So I don't get it. I mean, why wouldn't any of the lights on this flat Earth business be hitting the Earth's surface? It just so happens to hit the front of the moon, which is even a greater, which is even a smaller angle of convergence to the moon than it is to the sun. I mean, when I say small, I mean more acute. It's impossible, guys. That cannot possibly be correct. So the flat Earth model is a load of rubbish. That proves it's rubbish because you cannot possibly get a full moon. And no matter how much waffle somebody comes up with this angle convergence business, the angle convergence cannot go on the opposite side of the Earth, of the opposite side of the moon. It can go more or less direct. But even then, why isn't the sun disappearing? I mean, none of this makes any sense. So I'm saying it's bullshit, guys. I mean, the Earth is a sphere. It just is. It's just one of those things. Anyway, thank you for watching. Goodbye for now. See you later.